Hi, guys. I'm Phil Town from Rule One Investing, and today I want to give you a few really good book suggestions that aren't all investing related, but they'll help you with other areas of your life. Warren Buffett said before that about 80% of his day consists of reading. I feel the same way. That's what I really have to do to be a good investor. Everybody who's a good investor that I know reads a lot. Warren reads everything and attributes much of his success to it. I would agree completely. Having a great reading habit has tons of positive effects on you, which can include making more money. It can include it. But there are lots of other great things that happen to you as well. So next time you want to spend your weekend binge watching a new TV show, try reading one of these books instead for a much, much better and more powerful life. The first book is Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This book is such a classic and a must read for just about anyone interested in personal development and business and investing. Think and Grow Rich was written in 1937 after Napoleon Hill spent about 20 years interviewing many of the most successful people in the world at the time. And what he found was that virtually all of the most successful people followed a similar set of principles in their lives. He then created a list of what he called laws that any person can follow to become more successful in their life. It is a really, really powerful book. And virtually everyone that I know who's been successful at one time or another has read that book. So get that at the top of your list. Second book is Atlas Shrugged by Ayn Rand. This is one of the most popular books in the world. The theme of Atlas Shrugged, according to Ayn Rand, is the role of the mind in our human existence. It's the mind, the story shows, that's the root of all human knowledge and all values, and its absence, or the absence of the use of it, is the root of all evil. I personally think this is one of my favorite books in the world. I've probably read it, and by the way, it's this thick, and I bet I've read it about, I don't know, maybe 10 times. It is really incredibly deep. It's a deep philosophical book about how to view the world. And you'll see so much of what's going on in our world written in that book 60, 70 years ago. Third, The Success Principles by Jack Canfield. Jack is best known for co-authoring Chicken Soup for the Soul books, but I'm telling you, I think his most important book is The Success Principles. He is a genius at compiling the principles that people use to be successful, and he teaches in this book over 60 principles that will help you become more successful, and it will cover virtually every area of your life. It's a really great book. I was just up having lunch with Jack just a few weeks ago, and I gotta tell you, you know, you have a conversation and it just kind of rolls back to what's really important in your life. And this book nails it. It's a great book. It teaches you how to take responsibility for every area of your life in order to get from where you are to where you want to go. Jack's the best. The fourth book that I love is The Miracle Mindset by JJ Virgin. JJ is amazing. She's this incredible survivor, this incredible person who figured out how to bounce back from one of the most horrific things that can happen to any of us, and that is a serious injury to one of our children. JJ is a best-selling author. She's a good friend of mine. She's got a new book out called The Miracle Mindset. And in this book, she talks about this incredibly significant event that altered her life, that goes just unbelievable and incredible what she went through and how she survived it. And she takes a break from health and fitness because she's like the health and fitness guru out there. Love the things she's written before. But here she's talking about finding your true purpose, getting out of your comfort zone, facing up to your biggest challenges, and in how those biggest challenges can be the very thing that propels you into the life you always wanted. Great, great story. Prepare your hankies. The fifth is the Bhagavad Gita. This is an incredible book. It's an ancient part of Hindu scripture, and it introduces the concept of, I think, transcendence would be one way to think about it. The idea is that you can come into positions in your life where you have nothing except a rock on one side and a hard place on the other, and whatever you do, it looks wrong. This book is amazing as it walks through this ancient idea of how to get past those kinds of problems. In the story, this warrior has to go down and fight his own family, which he can't do because his love for his family is total and it's his responsibility to protect them as a warrior. But they're all on the wrong side. They're all on the wrong side of what's going on in this battle. And so they're on the evil side of things, and it's his duty as a warrior to stop evil. He can't move, and he's sitting down there in his chariot, and Krishna comes along to give him advice on how to solve the problem. It's an amazing book. It really says that we are here for a purpose. That's very important for us to find out what we're here to do and then act on it. And the most important thing in the book is what they call Yogastha Kuru Karmani in the original translation, which means get established in deep consciousness, right? Get transcendent, get deep and centered, and then take action. Just go for it. It's really a cool book. When you're doing that, when you're fully committed to that, nature is going to move in your way as well. And it's a stunning, stunning, very ancient text. Read it. It's only about this thick. You'd love it. Okay, one more book. This one's called Invested. It's written by my daughter Danielle Town, with me helping her. I write something that's in it. And what the book is about is her year of learning to invest. It follows along a lot of the ideas in our podcast, the Invested Podcast, which is one of the most popular business broadcasts out there. So this book is about Danielle starting from scratch, not wanting to be an investor, and pursuing her choices as she goes along, and ultimately learning to invest, and then ultimately making an investment that turned out her first investment to make her over 40% within a year. So this is a really cool book. It really explains a lot about fear of investing, about the process of going through a relationship between her dad and a daughter. And I'll tell you, it's just a really, really good book, and it's gonna be out in March 2018. Look forward to you guys picking it up, and you can go on Amazon and you can pre-order if you'd like. Now, I'd love to hear from you guys. What books have made a huge difference for you that I should add to my list? I've got a long reading list, love to add more to it. Having a library is one of the biggest deals for an investor. Get yours started, get these books. And you can leave a comment below with your answer, and I'll be sure to follow up with you. And thanks for watching, you guys. Now go play. Hey, you guys, if you enjoyed this video and you feel it was valuable in teaching you more about investing books, some of which have more to do with life, hit the like button and please share this video with your friends. And if you want more investing content, subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click the button on the screen for a free gift, okay? Thanks again for watching.